there are a lot of myths about breast cancer. I mean, if you think about the statistics here in this country, in the United States, 1 in 8, or depends who you read, 1 in 7 women are expected to get breast cancer in their lifetime. And of that, 85% have no family history. So the fact that we live here in the United States in this year increases our risk of having breast cancer, because you don't see these kinds of numbers in the Eastern world. My name is Dr. Shenin Sachedina, and I have the full privilege of just being the patient's doctor.
Her motto is passion and compassion, passion for our work and compassion for our patients.
I had talked to several other people and they said, you're the most lucky person in the world to have found this doctor. And I did feel that way. I just thought it's a, kind of an inverted blessing in a way to have that kind of care and that kind of respect you have for your doctor.
Dr. Sachedina was my breast surgeon, and I have to say, I feel so absolutely blessed that I got her. You know, she was recommended by my normal, you know, GP. And I can't even imagine having had someone besides her. She was so compassionate, so understanding.
I don't expect a lot, because I've just never been like that. I sort of live in the moment, and I go to where I'm supposed to be. And I believe that. I think wherever I'm meant to be is where I'll end up in life at any given moment. And I'm meant to do something at that point, wherever I am.
Knowing what I was going to be going through, I was very scared. Obviously very scared. So, sorry. She said, why don't you come back tomorrow? She couldn't do anything with me. I was just a mess. So I said, fine. So I went home and sort of got myself together and went back the next day, and we went through everything.
I had no idea how serious breast cancer was. And, you know, since it runs in everybody's family, it seems like it's just part of everyone's family now. So this for me was a great opportunity. And when she asked me, when she said she was working on this, you know, I'm thinking, yeah, fine, this is good. But as you know, Shenin is one of those folks that, what you call unstoppable, a force of will projected. When it's unstoppable, if she says she's going to do something, it's done.
I wrote Me Too and Lee Learn About Breast Cancer because we needed a resource for children for breast cancer.
Breast cancer is like a small camp that the bad guys set up in your mommy's breast. That's what she's going to do to them.
I've been doing this for over a decade. And the one thing I could truly realize is in these homes where children are touched by breast cancer, there were just not a lot of resources available. So I wrote this book to help educate these children about breast cancer and what to expect and so on. But actually the biggest thing that's come out of this whole Me Too and Lee project has been that it's given children a voice. Children need to be educated about what's going to happen to them, what breast cancer is. And the fact of the matter is, if you educate these children, they will handle things very, very well. That, again, your children don't need protection, they need education. I'm very good about being a mother and giving them their space to be children, and yet I hold being responsible and an education and all the things that they're supposed to do in very high standard. My children are incredible, and I'll tell you, I feel completely blessed because they are who they are, I can do so much more.
First and foremost, what an amazing gift to be able to tell somebody bad news and physically say, you know what, but I can help you, and physically do something for them. Take that tumor out, make things work out so that they get the best possible treatment and that they do well so that they can go back to their families and raise their kids and be with their families. I think that to me is a huge gift, and I have such a respect for that. I have such a respect for that. And I also have a huge respect for the fact that I can walk into a room and within seconds say the words, you have breast cancer, and change a woman's life.
She knows how to deal with women, and she knows how to deal with what's going on in their minds. And she's always very objective. She listens to you. She's not judgmental, whatever you decide to do.
My patients don't need this emotional roller coaster on my part. What they need is somebody who can come in, tell them what they have, tell them what the plan is, tell them how she's going to fix it, and then how she and I are going to grow together. That's the plan.
She's like this with all of her patients. She's just there for them, and she'll do anything for you. Since then, she and I have formed a really tight bond. Because I'm in production, she and I worked together on some PSAs that we did for Breast Cancer Month in October.
As for what's next, when you have great projects like Shenin's and everything else, when you have great projects like these, it shows you the direction that you're going to go. We learn by doing. So something tells me that the next chapter is not yet written. I'm going to put Doc on the spot. I think she should be writing a book on childhood obesity and diabetics.